the third start over the last five games after missing some time with that left ankle sprain, as he is going to go toe-to-toe with Fernando. And we are underway here on this Friday night in downtown Oklahoma City. Seal that victory. It was a big reason why the Thunder came out of that road trip with two wins. As Young's going to try to float it up, and that is the dunk for John Collins. Collins.
Man, he's just another coach on the floor. He just makes him so special.
Oh, what a move that time by Shea Gilgeous-Alexander from the wing. Allen was almost down.
I really like his game. He can post up. He's bouncy around the basket. Well, not that kind of bouncy.
The busiest month of the season continues for the Thunder, playing 9 games in 15 days. If you shrink it down even further, it's 5 games in 8 days as the Hawks come out of the timeout and score.
That's what you love. He's just very active away from the basketball.
Hunter steps back, fades away, and scores. That is DeAndre Hunter, as he's looking to shoot.
And that's also the identity of this team. They take a lot of threes. That's their bread and butter. How about this backdoor cut? Crochet not settling for that outside shot. He missed those two threes in the Eastern Conference.
Assists, fourth in the NBA is Gallinari. All kinds of height. All over Young. He could do that all day long if he wanted.
And not the Atlanta Hawks that they are today.
Long time ago. The NBA was still very young. Big lead early. The Thunder quietly kind of getting back in it as Muscala picks up where he left off in Orlando when he had a season high 4 threes.
Got the ability, Collins, to shoot the three. Can drive hard to the bucket, as you saw. Terrific offensive rebounder.
And Reddish with the floater on the baseline.
Lights out from the start. Kind of cooled off in that fourth quarter.
Reddish, another hard drive as he goes right at Muscala. So Cam Reddish, well, we have seen it. The unselfishness of this team throughout the season. The reason why their season high 7 games over 500. Finally cools off, but he thought he took a bump from Len.
Oh, he did, actually. A little bit too much contact.
And again, in transition, DeAndre Hunter. This Atlanta team, it takes a lot of threes, but it also gets inside. As you see, Teague right there took a bump out on the block, and he scores.
Under 3 seconds, you have 4.3 seconds. This is going to
pull up for the three, and knock it down just before the buzzer. Chris Paul played it perfectly. Paul thought about the three. Schroeder left open. Well, drive, floats it up, man. The vertical spacing yet again. This Thunder team, and he's playing with a lot of confidence, and it's showing up on a nightly basis for the Thunder, particularly in the absence of Steven Adams, as Teague floats it up and in as he got below the free throw line. Thunder defense has kept Atlanta quiet as Paul got around one, floats it up, and he's got another jump shot made. Chris Paul now with 9 points.
Are very familiar right now.
SGA, nice spin, got it over to Diallo, who's going to elevate on the baseline with the slam. Thunder again get a little extension on the lead, and how about Baisley going step for step with the 7-footer. Thunder in transition, SGA right down the lane, goes right by Collins and spins it home. 9 players who have scored tonight for the Thunder, really exemplary of how this Thunder team has played throughout this season, as Collins goes right at Muscala. Everybody seems to be stepping up at the right time, and you don't want to undervalue that, because finding reliable rotational pieces in the NBA is not all that easy.
And you know, as shooter lines up the three ball, he'll knock it down. And then some guys are just being themselves. Collins lines up a three ball, he'll knock that down as well. The shooter's just being himself, CP3 just being himself.
Slams it home.
Well, he said mouse in the house, and while he was saying it, he was turning baseline to dunk it. He turned away from the defense as well.
Lane sets that screen for Young. Steps back and drills another one, but that's a deep two. Now trying to drive. And Lane lost the handle. Gallo had it knocked away, but finds Nerlens Noel streaking to the bucket for another dunk.
Offense is clicking with those 33 points in the first quarter. 33 also in the second.
My goodness, Trae Young way off balance. In the All-Star game since, I should say, he's the first Hawk to start the All-Star game. And you know what everybody remembers him for? obviously the slam dunk contest, as Gallo sets it up, aims, fires, and hits from three. Not only does he have 20, but he's 9 out of 10 from the floor. Gallo, again from three with a quick response. With him are remarkable as Paul, driving down low, got caught below the rim, and Herter in transition with a two-handed slam. Now, are we talking like the same kind of dunk that he did in the Olympic game when he soared over? The Thunder here in this third quarter. And Gallo going at the rim, takes the bump, counted in the foul as he tumbles his way to the floor. Here is Young, the hard drive, lobs it up, and Collins again.
Like CP3, now he'll get caught with his hand in the cookie jar. But just great anticipation.
Hunter, hard drive, win at Gallinari. SGA from the wing, drives, and somehow spun it home. Trying to get it inside to Jones, shot clock under five. Teague off the dribble, pulls up. And Jeff Teague continues to be a pest to the Thunder this year.
I tell you, all the shots he's made from downtown, they have been just like that, where they've touched nothing but the center.
Eight-time All-Star, fun to see him in action here tonight. Shooter back outside, can Muscala line up another one? Yes, he can. Now the drive, kicks out. Catch fire three, that is good. Just over 2 minutes to go here in the third. Schroeder looking for that screen, left open. Carter dipped down, Schroeder takes advantage, and the Thunder with another triple from the outside. 9-point Thunder lead. Baisley now trying to get the step on Jones, high off the glass. We're taking a page out of SGA's book. Was able to shed Schroeder momentarily, takes the shot. How about the dive and the hustle from Schroeder? Thunder able to get out of the break, and Diallo takes the bump, counted in the foul. And it's white-hot shooting, particularly late in the quarter. Baisley gets things opened up here in the fourth quarter on a nice drive from the corner.
And how about another one, Jeff Teague?
Well, we can keep going all night. Paul, what a shot! Oh, my, the degree of difficulty on that step back over Herter. Needed every point, too.
Yeah, absolutely.
And that 20-point second quarter. Biggest output that he had in the quarter in his career. SGA again. The Hawks do not do a very good job of coming back in the fourth quarter. As Baisley muscles his way up and again banks it in. So he's had three drives on the night. But that's his first step back, and the Thunder certainly glad that he's taking a shot like that instead of the layup. My goodness. Gilgeous Alexander. He's the third top score from the draft from years ago as Collins slows down what was a 7-0 Thunder run.
He's averaging 8.6 assists a game. That's pretty impressive. Talk about going straight down Main Street there.
Since 1998, can you name the two guys from 98 who were 21 and under that went to the All-Star game?
Yeah, I'm just thinking because
Kobe was drafted in 96. Oh, what a move by Trae Young and the foul.
Section 119, row R, seats 3 and 4.
So spent a lot of time in this arena watching the Thunder do some work as SGA again. Your team is playing with so much confidence right now. Schroeder, one of the reasons why, even with that turnover, as we see Hunter. But it looks like Gallinari has a steal there.
But that's the thing about him. He looks great.
Baisley? See that move tonight. High. 8 games over 500. As Lou Dort, who started this game, will finish it. And that'll do it. That is the Thunder with an offensive surge in the second half. Really an offensive eruption.